Hey y'all, welcome back. Tiffany here. So listen, Insecure season 4 premiered last night, and honey, we're back for another season of all the tea, all the drama, all the nonsense, and all the friendship and love and good shit. So this season we're getting 10 episodes, which the way this one started, I know it's going to be messy, mess, and we're going to be really invested, so I honestly cannot wait. I'm going to give you guys a brief recap of the episode before I go into what I thought about it, my predictions for the next couple of episodes, so stay tuned. All right, so we start off on the episode, Issa on the phone, spilling some tea that gets us right popping. Like, she tells whoever she's talking to, I'm not really fucking with Molly right now. And by the way the episode goes, I get it. Move forward, they do this 4 months ago type situation, take you back to Issa and Molly hanging out, move into Issa and her new friend planning a block party to help out the community. We get Tiffany, we get Kelly. We find out that her new friend is Lawrence's girlfriend, which if you watch any of the trailers or the previews and stuff, you already knew that, so fine. We also find out that your girl Molly is finally giving Andrew, AKA Asian Bay, a chance, and he's still fine, y'all. Like, he came giving it in this episode. Basically, that's a synopsis. Not too much happens outside of that. We just go from self-care Sunday to block party. So that's what happened. Now my take on everything. So first off, when Issa is saying in the beginning, like, oh, I'm not fucking with Molly right now, as the episode progresses and you see how Molly acts, I totally get it. She still seems to be on the same childish stuff from last season. Though she's giving Asian Bay a chance, she ain't really changed. You know, she kind of goes to this thing of, he mentions that he's seeing other people. Instead of her just being honest and straight up right then and saying, no, I'm not seeing anyone else, it's just you, she acts all, you know, whatever about it. It's like, oh yeah, I'm seeing other people too, yada yada. Then pulls Issa aside and it's like, oh, I'm over it, I don't wanna be with him, childish. And then tells Issa she must love the drama and always wants to be in that stuff because she's still gonna be cool with Condola, who is Lawrence's new boo. I don't know. It just seems like she's telling Issa she loves the drama when she's the one who creates the drama. I mean, I get that she's a lawyer and she's like bossed up and she's living her life, but like, honestly, in comparison, she's only really doing better than Issa. I mean, the rest of their friend group outside of their like shenanigans and antics are really on their shit and like whatever. So I think Molly needs to humble herself a little bit and really realize that, like, baby girl, it's people out here living their lives, having really good jobs, and there are other fish in the sea for everybody else. Like, tighten up or just move on. I really don't want to do a whole season of, like, self-entitled Molly because that shit got real old last season. From Issa, I really feel like she's grown up. I think she's over the whole Lauren situation. She's trying to be mature. She's trying to live her life right and do the things she's passionate about. I'm excited to see how that progresses. I did think that Kelly would have had her baby already, but no, she's like super, super pregnant. So I predict that's gonna happen in the next episode or two because last we saw her was at the baby shower, which means she was like pretty much ready to pop. We didn't get any Joe or Candace, which I do hope that we get sometime this season and let that story develop a little bit. I want to see how that baby's doing, what goes on with that. Broke Ghost Bay, he wasn't in this first episode. Nathan, I really hope he doesn't come back. They mentioned Andrew wanting to know if he can come to the party, and Issa flat out says no, which I love because that means she's not still trying to play that tethered game with him. Let's see what else. Kelly was still Kelly. Super funny. I loved it. Still trying to aside whether or not we're canceling Lawrence, he seemed a little put off by the fact that Issa was the friend that Condola was working with on this new project, but he didn't stop her from doing it. He didn't make a fuss about it. He just kind of let it be what it was and let Condola make her own decision about it, which I did really like. They do also have a new show inside the show, which is like this murder mystery, absolutely hilarious situation. So I'm excited to keep on seeing that throughout the season. Overall, first episode, great. I love that it wasn't one of those nonsensical, just building story, didn't give us anything boring episodes. We've been there, we've done that, we've waited so long for season four. So they really just like jumped right back into the story and gave us tea. I'm excited to see what happens next. I'm so happy to have my Sundays back. You guys can tweet with me and watch it live together on Twitter. I'm at Tiff Says Go on there. Let me know what you thought about Insecure in the comments below. If you're watching it, drop your Twitter handles. I would love to connect with you and watch with you next Sunday and the Sunday after. I'm gonna be doing these updates each week, so stay tuned and get ready for one that's gonna come after next week's Insecure. In the meantime, in between time, make sure you like, subscribe, share with your homies, drop your comments below. Like I said, let me know what you thought about season 4, episode 1, and I'll see y'all next Sunday.